Hey guys, welcome back. So guys, in this video we are going to learn about RESTful API in Codeigniter 3. So we are going to do full CRUD thing in REST API for the web server. So guys, let's get started with it. So this is a simple blog which I have written for the Codeigniter 3 RESTful API tutorial using Postman. So we will be using Postman to fetch the data and send the data. Okay, so in this, because this is the best software to test the API things. So guys, now let us get started with it. So first we will be doing RESTful API, so we have to do use the package in our Codeigniter 3. So as you can see that there is a fresh application I have done with that Codeigniter 3, and here in this we have to will be doing API. So guys, first step, you have to get back to our blog and check with the Codeigniter server, okay, REST server. So to build this we will be using this. Okay, so guys, let's get started with that. Where you have to, if you want to download this REST server, you can go to the Google this and you will get a GitHub link over here directly, and from here you can download all the files and paste according to this blog. Okay, so as you can see, that's REST controller dot language for this, and then one is REST PHP, and then two file called resource controller and format.php. So in this three step we have to include in our Codeigniter file. Okay, so either you can use from here, just click on download, or else you can download this file from here and search in this src, and then take this format controller and REST, and then back for the language purpose to show the errors of this language from the English folder, you have to take this file. Okay, so same files I have attached in this blog. So let's click on it and get downloaded with it. So let me click. Okay, so download is downloaded now. So let's open this folder, show in folder. Here it is, and let's extract it. Extract here. Okay, so this is the key, and now inside this I'll just open this file. So four files we are getting it. So guys, let's get back to our blog, where in step one you are going to add this API, copy the file named REST controller and paste in your project as the following path. So you are going to language folder inside the REST where you'll be pasting it. So let's call that folder. So this is my application. So inside this application where languages, inside this languages English, where inside this English we have to paste that downloaded REST controller language. So I'm going to cut this directly. So cut and paste over here. So let's paste. Done. And then second step, we have to include this. So let's copy this REST.php file and paste into this path. So inside the config folder, rest.php. So let's get back to our downloads and let's cut this and paste back inside the application. This is our Codeigniter 3 API, where inside this applications folder I'm going to config and paste here. So let's paste, and then we will, these two files are remaining. As per the blog I have mentioned, copy the named resource controller and format, paste in the following path called libraries, and where this file will be, and inside the library again this file will be. So both file comes under same folder. So let's cut this both, control X, and you can paste under library. So let's open this and paste the file. That's it. So now let's open this in our editor. So guys, I have already opened that over here. So as you can see that inside library, we have already called these files. So guys, now let's get started with it. So guys, what we have to do is that let's test it. So guys, now what we'll do, let's start our PHP development server, which called -S localhost :8080. I'm going to hit, and our Codeigniter project will get started. So guys, if you want to use this PHP /localhost, you have to install your composer and start using it. So let's get back to Google Chrome and hit 8080, and let's load the server. Okay, so this is the application started. So guys, now we have to get back to our code, and now what we are going to do is that we will check the REST API security things. Okay, so once it is authenticated or API key is sent, that time it should be accessible in your Postman. Okay, so for example, I mean to say, like when you send the request, it should have some authentication, that means authorization and one API key. So to enable those things, we have to check with that. So guys, let's get started. So before that, we will check one dummy thing and we will check with the authentication thing. Okay, so let's get started with it. So let's go to our config folder and not rest routes.php. Okay, so let's open your route.php and create one route where with the simple name called api/demo, and in this demo we have to pass one, create one controller. So let's create one API folder. Inside that I'm going to create one, let's create API demo controller @index method. Okay, so let's get to our controller where I'll just show you how to get a demo with that. Okay, so we are going to check in this video about authorization things. So let's get to our controller folder. I'm going to create one folder called API. So let's create a folder API. Inside this, let me create API demo controller. So same name, I'm going to copy .php file, and the same name you have to paste over here. Okay, and same name, we are going to create a class with this. So as simple, where you're going to create the class where you're going to extend what controller you're going to extend. So we have to extend our REST controller. So I'll just show you one thing. REST controller, just type this REST controller controller. So this controller is coming from your library. So I'll just show you. So this is our library, and inside this is the REST controller. So you have to call this file inside here. Okay, so let's call this file. So what we have to do, we'll use this format to require over here, and inside this library I'm going to call this REST controller. So if you are doubt with the spelling, so let's copy this control C and paste over here, REST controller. That's it. So once set. And one more thing which we are forgetting, that the file should not be accessible. So you can go to your welcome where you can call this file as you know already. So let's mention that file and that's it. So your REST controller will be done. And now over here we will set this simple public function where I'm going to call this index method where you are going to set this. So what we have to do is that when this API is called, that time it will call this index method. Okay, so that time it will call this index method. So there is one thing in API, REST API, you have to call this function also. So I'll just tell you what is the concept behind this. So let me just echo called I am RESTful API. Okay, so let's save this and let's call this route. We are calling from, as you remember, it's not a code igniter controller, it's a REST controller. Okay, so let's save this. And now guys, what we have to do, let's get to a Google Chrome, make sure your development server is started, and let's paste this. So you see a REST controller not found under API controller. So let us call that. REST controller. Okay, we have to use this. So we didn't use that REST controller. We have to use one thing. Just use it over here. Let's paste. Okay, so this thing should be called because this package is calling, right? So this will use from here. So this thing, we are using this, calling this thing, and your then the name of your REST controller. That's it. And let's save this, and let's one more time, let's reload. So I'm going to reload. So you can see that status method, it is false, and error method unknown, because it is not showing the correct way. So why it is it showing this unknown method? We have to give the get method. Okay, so whenever you are creating this, you have to call this underscore get. Let's save this, and yes guys, let's load it. So you can see I am RESTful API. Then same thing you are going to test with this Postman also. So let us just paste it over here. And now guys, this is get method, so we are using get. This get is called from your API controller this. Okay, so this is the most important thing which plays the role inside your API Postman. Okay, so this is the very important thing. Now let's get that. So let's click on this REST send request, where you can see, okay, so I am RESTful API. So guys, as you saw that this is directly accessed now. Now what we have to do, we should make a security or something, like it should be very secure. So if anyone calls this route, that time it should not be accessed. Okay, so as for this, in this RESTful CodeIgniter API, in this rest.php file, we have some things like about the security thing. So we will be using API key. Okay, so we get API keys, right, from many payment gateways, many things. So in this also we will use API key to access this route, whatever you're fetching for it. So guys, until unless you pass that API key, until that it won't show you this RESTful API, whatever data is there. So guys, now let us get back and let's move to our rest.php file. So this is our rest.php file, and let us just scroll and check with it. So where is that actually? Okay, let me just see it. As you can see, this is the login thing. Okay, so this is used for login thing. That time if you required, you can make this login also, but we'll see in later further videos. But before that, we will see in this API key security thing. So let's move with it. Okay, and okay, here is this. Okay, so you are going to create REST key table. Okay, so with the name keys, and what are the things should be created are these datas. Okay, so guys, now let's create one table. So we will just rename this table as API underscore key. Okay, so because key table keys is already predefined thing in our MySQL PHP MyAdmin. So let's rename this table and create it. So let's get back to our database, and over here, let me click on new. So let's click on new and create one table into it. Okay, so let's assign the table name, and inside this, you're going to create all the columns which is required over here. So as you can see, ID, user ID, key, level, ignore limits. So all these things will be called in it. So let us just type and create with that 11, where we will set this as primary key. Let's set this. It's loading. Okay, let's go with it. Auto increment. And then the user ID, we have to call, where this will also be an int. 11, it will be not null. And then call this thing key and level. Okay, so let's type that KY key and level. This key will be as varchar 40. Okay, so let's take that as varchar 40. And level will be as integer right now. So we'll just give this 2. And how many more fields we need to add? 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's copy this, and more 4 fields we required. Type 4, go create the columns, add this, ignore limits, which is tiny int, and private key is also tiny int. So let's just set this tiny int. So it's make sure you're searching int. Someone will check off alpha also. So please make sure you're not adding something like different. So make sure you're adding integer only, because with this simple mistake, your table will be created as mistake wise. Let's add this, and you can see that it is not null, not null, and this IP address which is null, and it is as text. So let us just add with this IP address where you are going to keep as text, and we will select this as null. So where is it? Null. Okay, see, this is the null column. We are going to select null and make here also null. Okay, so make sure these things are there, and then finally created date, and it's shown as integer, but we will not use this int value, we will use timestamp. So let's click on this and we will use this timestamp, and here we are going to send current timestamp, and let's click to save. So name key is a reserved name, so let us cancel this, and let's make sure we are giving to this key name, as we will rename it like my key, my underscore key, we are going to rename this. Okay, so we'll just rename, because that is the predefined thing, and we will change this column also. So let's copy this, and now let's save it. Click on save. Processing request. Okay, so your API key table is created. Now you have changed this my key. Okay, so this is my key, you have to change in your REST API. So as you can, if you go below at line number 338 over here, you are going to paste that my key. Okay, so this column will be redirected. As you can see that it is example my key only they have specified, so we can use this as my key. So let's save this, and now we have to set this as true. So let us just make it true and done. So now we will access directly. So for this testing thing, we will go back to our Google Chrome and load this URL. So let's hit enter. You can see invalid API key. Okay, so there is no such API key. Now let's test with the postman also. So let me just click on this, and let's call the same URL for the same result we are going to call. So let me just send. So you can see that here is the result now you are getting. Okay, so invalid API key. So guys, now we have to set an API key for it. So let's get back to a Chrome, and let's go to a browser where I'm going to insert a data. So let's insert user ID. I don't have right now, so I'm just going to give 0 right now. And my key over here will give funda 123, and level right now we have 0, so ignore 0 limits, private 0, and this IP address just ignore that, and current timestamp will be there. Okay, so let's keep it as all 0, and let us say go. Okay, so let me browse it. Done. And yep guys, so my API key is right now this, right? For the demo purpose, I have kept very small. You can random generated key for each user, you can just do with that thing. So guys, now let's copy this and pass this in your postman. So we don't have for this API like on this one, so we need to implement that thing on your browser if you required through send through API. Okay, so right now we don't have the user interface to directly. So let's get started with this. So guys, now what you have to do, go to your header and paste the key over here. Okay, so you have to give the key name and you have the value over here. So what value will you give for this? So it's, let's go to our browser, I mean CodeIgniter. And below that you have a code called, okay, so this is the path for your calling your API key. Okay, specific API key if you want to call this header. So let's copy this, it's line number 380, and let's go to postman and paste that over here. That's it. And now let us call this. So right now it's showing invalid, so let's us send the request again and get it. So guys, let's see. Cool, so you have seen that the outputs have come. So guys, now as you have got this output with this API key, right? So guys, now we have to check with that login thing also. So once you give the basic login where we are going to do. Okay, so you have to select this and provide the username and password. For example, I have given this admin, and over here password is 1234 I have given for testing purpose. Okay, so guys, let's do this thing configuration and we will check with it. So right now I will click on this and let me send. So you will get one message. So let us just send over here. You can see the output is coming, right? So to make this secure, these things all should be accessible. So that thing we will get set up. So guys, first step, as we are in the rest.php file, over here we have to set up the things for it. So guys, as I have written in the blog, where you can see that securing the API method 1. So method 2, which we have learnt about this using API key, which we did now. And now this is the login things for securing it. So guys, as we have to set this, so first you have to go over here and you can change your credential and your admin. So let's go to this path rest.php where you can find this. So let me copy this and search. Okay, so as you can see, this is admin and 1234. If you want to change your password, you can change and set up with this. Then second thing, what we have to do, change this details into it. So default will be this rest auth false. So let us copy this and just search with that. So control F and F V. Okay, so this is the false thing, which it is set that no login required. If you just give, so as you saw that when you're sending, it's not validating this password, email and password. So as for that, to make it validate, so let me just comment it and let's copy and paste once again and choose this basic. So let's put it in single quotes with basic. So if you give basic, you are going to check the login credentials for it. So let us just before, if you use this, you have to set somewhere the basic routing thing. So just scroll it little down, you can see that auth source. Okay, so this is the source where you are choosing for ID AP. Okay, so this one we are not going to take this. So let's copy and paste and let us comment this and leave it blank. So it will be just normal thing. So this is one method of doing. So we have many things. Okay, so there are 1, 2, 3 type of login. So we are going to use this first, where null one. So without this, it cannot be used. So now set up, and then now let us get back to our postman and let's send it again. So I'm removing this username and password and let's send the request. Now you have to see something unauthorized. So let us, it's still sending request, where you can see that status false and error is unauthorized. So it is not authorized. To make it authorized, you have to copy your credentials. So what is that credential? Is that admin 1234 I have given. So let me just show you where it is. Okay, so these are the rest valid logins. So let us copy this admin and where is it? Here, let's get back admin and here 1234 and let's send. Let us just wait for it. Cool. So you are getting the REST API. So guys, this is working as you saw in the beginning only. So guys, in this video, we have completed that how to make this login authorized API and with your headers, that is nothing but your API key. Okay. So you are checking with the authentication login also and with the API key token or whatever you say in your thing. Okay. So guys, we have completed the full authorization auth login for the REST API and let's continue in next video about making CRUD application in API. So guys, thank you for watching this video and please subscribe, like and share.